that some of the key people in your journey.
Mm.
And I know you were a Waipara, it was probably a start out after school.
Yep.
So, you know, what were some of those key points in that journey?
It's been quite strategic, I suppose, in my career, and made some good decisions, and going to Waipara was certainly one of those. Got involved with the beef and lamb thing and managed to go overseas to France and do that, which was an awesome experience. I actually wanted to go shepherding. I was dead set on going shepherding. All I wanted to do was go out and work my dogs. But after doing that and seeing, opened my eyes to, you know, how big the world is and how far, the sheep industry could take me if I wanted to do anything other than chase sheep. So that probably pushed me towards maybe I should go to Lincoln and sacrifice a couple of years, which I'm also very glad I did, because I met my lovely wife, Charlotte, and made a whole lot of networking and met a lot of cool people. So, those are a couple of big ones. And then, managed to work for some really good people and on some good farms, and now got the opportunity to work for ourselves. So.
Well, I want to pick up with Charlotte, because I obviously picked through there, you guys are a team.
Yeah.
So where do you think your team's going to be another 5 years? What's the plan you want to try and achieve, Charlotte?
Well, our ultimate goal is obviously farm ownership. To get there, obviously I'm working off-farm with my full-time role with Orflex and MSD and my cut flower business and the native nursery, which has picked up heaps lately. So probably we'll start to see a bit of a change in more time spent with the native nursery to help us get to where we want to be with farm ownership, and hopefully that all works.
Hey, look, all the best you guys, and keep achieving. Hey, it's bloody brilliant what the story you guys have been telling. Thanks so much.
Thank you very much.